In the previous lesson, we looked at efficient implementation of mutual exclusion lock algorithms. In this lesson, we're going to look at barrier synchronization, how to implement that efficiently in the operating system. And just to refresh your memory about the barrier synchronization works like this, that you have a bunch of processors, and they all need to know where they are with respect to each other, where they want to reach a barrier, and they want to wait here until everybody has arrived at this barrier. So if T1 arrives at the barrier, it's going to wait until everybody else has come. So one of the guys, maybe a straggler, is going to come a little later, and in that case, everybody has to wait until all the threads that are part of this application have arrived at the barrier, then they can move on. And I mentioned to you that this kind of synchronization is very popular in scientific applications, and they go through these phases where they execute code for a while, reach a barrier, and then execute code for a while, reach another barrier, execute code for a while, reach another barrier, and so on and so forth. And I mentioned also that in real life, this happens quite often when we go to a dinner with a bunch of our friends, and some of us show up early and others come late. The usher is going to hold us all ransom. Wait till everyone is here. Until then, I cannot seat you. So that same sort of thing that's happening with the barrier, that all of the threads have to arrive at the barrier. Only then they can proceed on. So that's the semantic of the barrier synchronization. And I'm going to describe to you a very simple implementation of this barrier. The first algorithm I'm going to describe to you is what is called a centralized barrier, or also sometimes called a counting barrier. So centralized barrier, counting barrier, that's a name that's given to this. The idea is very, very simple. You have a counter, that's why it's called a counting barrier. You have a counter, and that counter is initialized to n, where n is the number of threads that need to synchronize at the barrier. And what is going to happen is that when a thread arrives at the barrier, it's going to atomically decrement the count. Key thing is it has to be done atomically. So once it is atomically decremented the count, then it's going to wait for the count to become zero. So long as the count is not zero, it's going to wait. So if the count is zero, we're going to do something else. But if the count is not zero, that means that I have arrived at the barrier, but I don't know where the others are yet. So I'm going to wait. So they're going to spin. And the spin is basically saying, while count is greater than zero, spin. And all the processors, except the last one, are going to be doing this spinning on count becoming zero. Now, the last processor, the straggler, maybe the T2 is the straggler, and the straggler arrives eventually, and when he arrives, then what he's going to do is he's going to decrement also, and when he decrements the count, he'll see that the count has become zero, and so what he will do is he'll reset the count back up to n, and that is indication that everybody, so all of these guys are waiting on count being greater than zero. So as soon as the count becomes zero, then they can be released from the barrier, and the last processor to arrive is going to reset the count to n to indicate that when these guys go off before they come to the next barrier, the count has to be n. So that's the idea behind that. So very simple algorithm: decrement the count atomically when you come to the barrier. If the count is greater than zero, then you know that everybody has not arrived. Spin, and everybody except the last guy will do the spin. And the last guy that comes around decrements the counter, and the counter becomes zero. And once the counter becomes zero, all the guys that are stuck here, they're going to be released. And then the last processor is going to reset this count to n so that, you know, all these guys are now on their way to the next barrier. So it is resetting it to n so that the barrier can be executed again when all these guys get to the next barrier. That's the idea behind the centralized barrier.